Hello viewers, please like, subscribe and share my channel. Do not forget to hit the bell icon.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Aditya's Diaries once again. Here I am Aditya, your little guide, and today to tell you something about gravity. If you want to know more about gravity, then please watch the video till the end, and you know it's very interesting. So gravity is like an illusion of force when a heavy object lies in between of the fabric of space. You know what's the fabric of space? It is made of parallel lines. Every time when you learn geometry, the first thing you learn is about parallel lines. So in this fabric of space, one line is of space and one line is of time. So it can be called as space-time. So here when a heavy object lies in between, it bends the space-time. And here when a marble, or it's a planet, as this is a star, the smaller one is a planet, rotates around it or orbits it. But after a certain amount of time, it is pulled towards the center of mass, or this object with the highest mass, as at a certain amount of time it loses its energy. The energy of moving is called kinetic energy. So when it loses its kinetic energy, it's pulled towards the gravitational force. So this is what it happens. And this object also has some weight. And this also bends the space-time a bit. That's why if another object is rolled along with it, this object tried to first orbit this, and along with it orbit this star. If it is considered as sun, this is earth, and this is its natural satellite moon. So here's one earth, here's moon. So due to the gravity of earth, as earth also bends space-time, but due to this it is visible less. So when it rotates, it will orbit around earth and the earth will orbit around sun. But after a certain amount of time, the earth will lose its kinetic energy and would crash into the sun. That's really going to happen, but as everything in space has a humongous amount of distance between it, it cannot be calculated in miles and it has to be calculated in astronomical units and light years. So it will take a lot of time. As you know, you would be thinking about a black hole. That how does it gain so much mass, and why is it actually called a black hole? It's called a black hole because its mass increases so much, like this, this and this. And there's a lot of mass in it, almost like 13 and 15 suns. However, it's compressed so much that the gravity of it increases and it tears away the fabric of space that causes a hole. And as you know, this part is holding it along. If there will be a hole in between, everything will just go down and the whole thing will become a hole. So everything will fall faster than anything in a hole, no? If this one is a slanting surface and this one is a straight surface, in which one will the movement be faster? In a straight surface, which is actually vertical. So that's why the black hole is called a black hole, and it tears away the fabric of space. So if there would be, as you know, if there would be a hole in this space-time, and there would be a mass of lot of things engaged together in this seat, then the seat may tear, as there's a capacity of space also. So if there would be compressed mass, like it would be like, if you were visualizing how to compress and how are the neutron stars compressed so small that they form black hole. So it's almost like it's a whole 350 feet long stadium and it compressed into just a dust. So the electrons and protons inside it will compress together and form the neutrons, and this would cause such a high nuclear fusion that it would just, everything will go inside. There's a lot of layers inside this star. So when you see this oxygen, nickel and everything can release energy, but one thing cannot, that's iron. When everything burns out and the fuel goes off, as here there's gravity and inside there's a nuclear fusion force that keeps the star in balance. But after many time, all the fuels, the star has lot of fuels, no? So when the fuels start evolving or they start, one fuel will finish then another will start. At last the iron is there. So when it reaches the iron does not produce any amount of energy to hold the gravity that's pushing inwards. So when the iron comes out, so it just spreads till the core of the star and the whole star is compressed due to the force of gravity as the iron produces no force against it. So friends, that's how the black hole is formed and that's what the gravity is. It's just like an illusion of force, but it can be said as a force as this thing requires two force, which is frictional force and kinetic energy, and when it stops here the potential energy, all types of energy and forces are used here, so gravity can be said as a force. So friends, thanks for watching this video. Please share this and like this video, subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching. Bye.